My name is Sumit.
And my name is Anjali.
And you are watching our channel,
Canada Wale Sharma.
Hello everyone, in this video we are going to discuss about the new immigration pathway introduced by Newfoundland and Labrador Province. So Newfoundland and Labrador PNP program announcement which has recently came. The province is looking to attract highly educated and highly skilled newcomers to stay, and this news has come on November 18th when the provincial government has announced under the Newfoundland and Labrador Provincial Nomination Program, also called as NLPNP. We will talk about it now. Okay, the first one is Masters or PhD graduates of Memorial or University who graduated within the last 3 years with a degree related to Information Technology, Ocean Technology, Healthcare, Agriculture and Aquaculture. So those people will be eligible as the first one in the priority skills pathway. The second one is, in addition to that, the professionals with work experience in other highly skilled high demand occupations, they will be considered, such as software developer, biomedical engineer, UI/UX developer, AI developer, mechanical engineer, .NET developer, infrastructure engineer, security specialist, computer network support, bioinformatician, etc. So those who demonstrate these skills will be considered. Individuals also are required to have a high language proficiency either in English in one of the language tests, and they should be scoring a Canadian language benchmark of level 5 or more. That is also required by under the provincial nomination program. So there are also other ways to immigrate to Newfoundland and Labrador. So the NLPNP, Newfoundland and Labrador PNP is divided into 5 categories. The first one is Express Entry Skilled Worker category. It allows the province to nominate the skilled workers through Canada's Federal Express Entry System. Nominated individuals need to have job offers in the province. The second one is Skilled Worker category, where it is targeting the individuals who have received the job offers from an employer in the province. This category also targets the people who are already working in the province on a valid work permit. The third one is International Graduate category. This focuses on the recent graduates who are the holders of postgraduate work permit. They must have a job or a job offer in the province. The fourth one is International Entrepreneur category, which provides a pathway to permanent residence of international graduates who wish to start or run a business within the province. In addition to these 5 categories, the fifth one is also the Atlantic Immigration Pilot Program. So we will talk about this in other videos in detail. So to qualify for that as well, the candidates must have a job offer in the province. Okay, so we also want to, whatever information we have shared with you, we will show you, it's also there on the Newfoundland and Labrador Province immigration page. It's under new releases. So if you go onto their website, you can type under new releases, you will see this information. And this program is launching, which is called as NLPNP. It is launching on January 2, 2021, so it's just coming soon. And whatever information we have shared with you, like which are eligible, Memorial University and the high demand occupations, every information is already there. And they have also mentioned that even though they have posed a lot of challenges due to COVID-19 pandemic, but the future growth and the 2021 and 2022 targets, they're increasing the immigration to 2,500 new permanent residents annually. And these numbers are apart from the federal government numbers of immigration, separately the province what they are targeting. And if you go down as well, you will see that what all profiles and what kind of job roles they are targeting, which we have already discussed with you. And in the end, they have shown like the scenarios. Okay, if you go by these scenarios, there are different kind of case scenarios which Newfoundland and Labrador province has given. Such example is like a post-secondary graduate, where they have mentioned that he has done his master's from Memorial University, which is already there in Newfoundland and Labrador, and he has been working there Another example is of another candidate with work experience who has been working in Newfoundland and Labrador for two of all total those 3 years, and another person orderly who's also working for a major Canadian IT company. So from all these scenarios, what we can see is that Newfoundland and Labrador is preferably given to the person who's already working in that province under the IT companies or other companies. So they would prefer those persons with the work experience in those major companies over there. These kind of examples are already there. Hope these examples will also help you in order to present your scenario and go ahead with these newly implemented provincial nomination programs.
Thank you, Anjali, for such a wonderful update.
So hope you guys have liked our video, and also please do watch our previous videos, link is there. And also please like our videos, share our videos and subscribe our channel. And the people who are watching our videos and they are not subscribing, please do subscribe as well. Yes. Please also follow us on Instagram and Facebook page
with
by the name Kandawale Sharmas.
Till then, stay tuned
and thank you. Bye.
Bye.